Hi children, and how are yours? In this video I'm going to explain about the potential energy of an electric dipole placed in uniform electric field. Potential energy of an electric dipole placed in uniform electric field. So this is the topic for today's video. And children, I already explained what is mean by dipole and what is mean by uniform electric field. What is mean by uniform electric field? In an electric field intensity is same at every point, both in magnitude and direction. Then that electric field is called uniform electric field. Uniform electric field is nothing but the field which consists of electric field intensity is same at every point in the field. That should be called uniform electric field. And what is mean by dipole? Two equal and opposite charges are separated by some distance. That should be what we call uniform electric field, that is two charges separated by equal distance. That should be what we call electric dipole. So how the electric dipole can experiences while it is placed in uniform electric field, that is the topic for today's class. Okay children, look here, already one diagram it is there on the board. Just I want to explain that briefly here, just watch it. So children, my request is, while you are watching the video, don't skip the video. You can watch the video without skipping, then only my content will reaches you. I am sure about that. So just see here how we can represent the uniform electric field with field lines. Simply all the field lines are in the same direction. In a field we are showing like this. Electric field lines are all are in the same direction and they are separated by equal magnitudes. Then that field is commonly noted as uniform electric field. In that electric field here, so this is a positive charge. Generally what we say dipole, for example here this is the negative charge and this is the positive charge, minus Q, and now it is plus Q. Both charges are separated by equal charges. So separated by some distance, that is what I am saying here, that is 2A. Distance of dipole is what? 2A. That is nothing but separation of two charges. Clear? Equal and opposite charges should be separated by some distance. That should be what we know, electric dipole. Here we are taken dipole length is 2a, and here that dipole should be placed like this, and this is a minus Q and this is a plus Q. Here the dipole will make some angle theta. It will make some angle theta with the direction of the field. So I explained same topic in previous chapter. What's that? Derive the expression for torque acting on the couple, a torque or couple acting on the dipole. Clear? The same topic, same answer, but little bit small changes in at the end of the topic. In I already created one playlist for the previous chapter also, you can go and watch it once. Derive the expression for couple or torque acting on a dipole, the same topic I explained there. That's why I'm not going to the same topic much more. Simply here while we are taking a dipole that should be placed in the uniform electric field, that will make some angle theta. Here now, while the dipole is placed in the uniform electric field, some force is acting on the positive charge, and same time the negative charge will be acts on the same thing. already we know that electric field intensity means what? When we can keep some charge in the electric field of another charge, that should be experience of some force. There is some force acting on the charge while it is placed in the electric field of another charge. That is commonly what we call electric field intensity. That's why here E is equals to what you have? E is equals to F by Q. From that what you write? F is equals to QE. F is equals to QE. Clear? That's why here what I have to say, when some force is acting on the charge in the electric field. So obviously here also two charges are there. Some force is acting on the charge plus Q and it is minus Q. That means here the electric field intensity what we are taking field is same. That's why here the S, when the electric field intensity is same, then the same amount of force acting on the two charges but in opposite directions. Clear? Got my point? Here the electric field intensity is same. That's why the two charges what we are taken, they are also equal. We are taken two equal charges and these charges must be kept in the field of same intensity. Then obviously same amount of force acting on the two charges. When plus Q on plus Q, what you have? General equation is what it is, force F is equals to QE. On plus Q charge, QE charge will be acts. And here the force acting on the negative charge is minus QE. Minus QE. So the same thing will be shown in this diagram. Clear? Already I told on that time. What's that? When two equal forces which are in magnitude same and they are in opposite two, when two equal amount of forces acting on a dipole in opposite directions, then obviously the dipole can constitute a torque. Constitutes the torque or couple. Clear? So I explained in the same thing here in previous chapter. Just go and watch it once. So that's why here I am explaining very briefly. Here simply look here. We are taking a dipole of length 2A. That should be placed in the uniform electric field of intensity E. Then same amount of force acting on the positive charge and negative charge. Then these two forces can make the dipole to rotate in the electric field. So that is what we call generally couple or torque. What do you say? Couple or torque. So in this case, I am writing here now couple or torque. How we can define the torque? Magnitude of force into perpendicular distance between two forces. So couple torque or torque, magnitude of force into perpendicular distance. What I told you, how much force is acting on each charge? QE. On plus Q charge, QE. On minus Q charge, minus QE. So we have to consider only magnitude. That's why I am writing here, force is here I am writing. So here, tau is equals to, magnitude of force is how much? QE. QE into, in this diagram, the perpendicular distance between these two. This is the one force and this is the another force. From these two, perpendicular distance is nothing but here, BC. So here we are adding tau is equals to QE into BC. What it is? BC. Here what is BC? Perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance. Here to get the value of BC, you can observe the triangle like this. This is the one triangle what you are finding in the diagram. This is A and this is B and this is C. The initially the dipole will make some angle theta. Dipole will make some angle theta. That's why here we are reading like this, theta. Now here this is the angle theta. What is that? This is the angle theta. So here A, B, C. So from that I am writing now sin theta. What do you write? From that I am writing sin theta is equal from figure, from triangle A, B, C. You will write, what do you write? Sin theta is equal to what? Generally opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. Here what is the opposite side? BC. And what is the hypotenuse? AB. Here opposite side is what? BC. BC by, here hypotenuse is what? AB. Children, what I told you? Here nothing but this is what? Minus Q and this is plus Q. This is what? Nothing but dipole. Here AB is nothing but what? Dipole length. That is what? 2A. What we are taking? That is 2A. So here I am writing now sin theta is equals to BC by 2A. From that what you write? BC is equals to 2A sin theta. BC is equals to what? 2A sin theta. Substitute this value in equation number 1. So here what you write, children? Tau is equals to QE. Tau is equals to what, right? QE into 2A sin theta. 2A sin theta. From that, children, I am writing here tau is equals to, for our convenience we are writing 2A into Q into E sin theta. The same thing will be written as like this. Tau is equals to 2A into Q E sin theta. Here what is 2A? Length of the dipole. And what is Q? Magnitude of charge. Product of magnitude of charge and dipole length, what we call dipole moment. What we call dipole moment. So then tau is equals to what, right? P E sin theta. So what is that? Tau is equals to P E sin theta. Clear? So this is what amount of torque. Amount of torque or couple acting on the dipole. Up to here we discussed in the previous chapter video, same thing. So here small changes from this one. From this onwards, small little bit of changes are there. Just look here. Now here there is some work done by the dipole. There is some work done by the dipole to make an angle d theta. That should be shown like this. Here dw is equals to tau into d theta. Dw is equals to tau into d theta. What is dw? Small amount of work done. What's that? Small amount of work done to move the dipole by the angle of d theta. By the angle of d theta. So this is the small amount of work done. Now we have to substitute the value of tau there. This is the equation number 2. From that what right? Dw is equals to P E sin theta into d theta. This is the small amount of work done to move the or to make the angle by rotation, angle of rotation how much? D theta. Here d theta is what? Angle of rotation by the dipole. For example, here now we will consider that the dipole will make some angle from theta 1 to theta 2. Here dipole changes from theta 1 to theta 2, for example 30 to 60, like that. So then also there is some work done. To get the work done, that we have to integrate this equation. So here the amount of work done to move the, here what you say, the amount of work done by the dipole to rotate the dipole, here theta 1 to theta 2, how much will be E sin theta d theta. This is the total amount of work done to rotate the dipole from angle theta 1 to theta 2. There is some work is going to be performed to move the or to rotate the dipole from angle theta 1 to theta 2. So here you have to observe P E sin theta. Here what is P? dipole moment. Dipole moment equation is what? 2aq. Here 2a is length of dipole and q is charge. Here 2aq, it is the magnitude of product of dipole length and charge. Here dipole moment is constant because 2a is constant, q is constant. So in this equation p is constant. And what we have taken? Uniform electric field. Uniform electric field, that's why E also constant. Electric field intensity also constant. That means here what will change is only the angle will be changes. Here the angle can be variable. So here we are indicating that what here double E is equals to P E integral sin theta d theta. So again theta 1, theta 2. So integral sin x dx is what? Cos x. So like that, your formula is what? P E cos theta integral theta 1 to theta 2. Limits are theta 1 to theta 2. Since what you know? Integral sin x is equals to sin x dx is equals to what, right? Cos x. This is the formula. Like that, integral sin theta d theta means what? Cos theta. Now here what you are right? Double E is equals to P E into cos theta 2 or cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. This is the total amount of work done. What is that? Total amount of work done. So what do you get, children? Double E is equals to P E cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. So here the same amount of work done is nothing but here potential energy. U is equals to P cos of theta 2 minus theta 1. This is the expression for potential energy. The amount of work done to move the or to rotate the dipole from theta 1 to theta 2. Theta 1 to theta 2. So if you can take theta 1 is more, theta 2 is less, then what do you get? Cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2, like that. Clear? So here I am taking theta 1 to theta 2. Then what do you get? U is equals to PE cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. In this case, you may take U is equal, I am writing here theta 2 is equals to 90 degrees and theta 1 is equals to 0. Theta 1 is equals to 0. Then what you get? U is equals to PE cos 90 minus cos 0. Then what you get? U is equals to minus PE cos 0. Cos 0 means what? 1. Then U is equals to minus P. Yeah. PE. U is equals to minus PE. That means simply here, when theta is equals to 90, cos 90 is 0, this is the cos 0 is 1. Then what you get? U is equals to minus PE cos 0, then U is equals to minus PE. That means here simply what you get? U is nothing but here P cross E. What's that? P cross E. So potential energy is nothing but negative of, what is that? Vector product. U is equals to P cross E. Children, so this is about the potential energy of an electric dipole placed in uniform electric field. Simply here U is equals to minus P cross E. Okay, let us see once again here. This is the one of the important topic, important question for 4 marks. Look here. We have taken uniform electric field. In that one dipole is placed. Dipole length is what is 2A. So here this is the minus Q charge and this is the plus Q charge. When it is placed, the dipole is placed in the uniform electric field, there is some force is acting on the positive charges QE and now it is on negative charges minus QE. When two equal forces acting on dipole in opposite directions, then obviously here what you get, the dipole will consist the torque. That's why here what you write, torque is equals to magnitude of force into perpendicular distance. Here magnitude of force is what? QE. And in figure, what is the perpendicular distance? BC. Clear? Tau is equals to QE into BC. That is equation number 1. After that, from the figure, what we write? Sin theta is equals to BC by AB. Here angle it is theta is there. So this one now it is BC is opposite side. and AB is the hypotenuse. So then what you get? BC is equals to 2A sine theta. Now I am substituting BC value in equation number 1. Then what you get here? Tau is equals to QE into 2A sine theta. Again 2A into Q means what? That is the dipole moment. That's what you get. Tau is equals to PE sine theta. This is the amount of couple or torque acting on the dipole in the uniform electric field. So after that, here we have to go for one assumption. That what is that? Small amount of work done to rotate the dipole by the angle of d theta, that is given by d double is equals to tau into d theta. Then here d double is equals to all tau value is b sine theta d theta. Now if the dipole is wants to move or rotate it from angle theta 1 to theta 2, theta 1 to theta 2. Here I am saying theta 1 is the lower limit and theta 2 is the upper limit. So to get the total value, to get the total amount of work done by the rotating the dipole from theta 1 to theta 2 angle, that is given by just by integrating this equation on both sides. Then what you get? Here double E is equals to PE sin theta theta d theta. Here it is in form of sin x dx, that is equals to what? Cos x. So here after that we are substituting limits. W is equals to PE of cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. So this is the total amount of work done to move the to rotate the dipole from angle theta 1 to theta 2. This amount of work done is nothing but potential energy of the electric dipole. So U is equals to PE cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. And if you can consider that from 0 to 90, if it is rotated from 0 to 90 degrees, then we can write U is equals to PE cos 90 minus cos 0. Then what you get? U is equals to minus PE cos 0. Cos 0 value is 1. So that means simply here U is equals to what? Minus PE. So here then what you get? U is equals to minus PE minus nothing but it is the in vector form of P cross E. Potential energy nothing but vector form of the P cross E. So this is the potential energy of an electric dipole in uniform electric field, children. So this is the topic for this video, children. So I hope you understand. If you can understand this video, like, share and comment the video. Subscribe my channel for latest notifications to get the full clarity about the subject. Okay, so I hope you children understand that the topic very clearly. So we will meet in the next video with some other interesting topic. Bye, take care children. We will take care. Bye, take care. We will meet in the next video with some other interesting topic. Bye, see you soon.